You are hanging out in the break room. We are live from Buffalo Bills training camp. Getting the inside scoop on Bills camp. Thanks in part to Perry's Ice Cream. Life is a bowl of Perry's. Just talked to James Wilder Jr. Tommy wants to.
What a great kid.
You want to go hang out with his family in
Tampa.
Oh, my
God. Don't you?
Well,
they got to be a riot.
You want to go? You want to go hang?
I mean, he's such a good guy.
Well, if we're going to go travel, I got the perfect guy that can go with
Who's
us.
Who's going to go with us?
We are sitting down with Buffalo Bills wide receiver Greg Salas. Word is that he's doing so well that, I mean, do you read about what they're saying about you?
You try not to. You don't really read, but, you know, you can't help but hear it from, you know, your family or your friends. Like, you know, did you see what they wrote about you or something like that? But, you know, I try to stay away from that.
Buffalo Bills wide receiver Greg Salas sitting in the Stoneyard Brewing Company hot seat. If you follow Greg Salas' Instagram, it's like...
The Travel Channel?
It's like, yeah, it's National Geographic.
Guy's been all over the world.
You went on a world vacation with your wife this offseason?
Yeah. Lucky me, because she got that from her father for her graduation gift.
Whoa.
I kind of got to tag along. And
So you're graduating, you get to go all over.
Yeah, that was kind of their deal that they had in place, you know, growing up. You know, he says, as soon as you, when you graduate college, I'll send you on a round-the-world trip. And he honored his promise, and I got to tag
along.
How long of a trip was it?
It was 6 weeks.
6 weeks.
Holy cow!
Yeah.
Now, hold on. Before we get into the trip, your wife is not only married to a guy that's going to bring home an NFL paycheck, but she also has a father that obviously has money. How is that fair to any other woman on the planet?
And you went to school in Hawaii.
Yes.
Yeah. She just get the hell out of here.
She actually went to poor kid.
You were saying, Greg?
Oh man, you guys are too much.
You sleeping in your Ferrari last night?
I was actually a Lamborghini, but sure. Close.
Well, one of the ones Mario left.
Yeah, right. Just leaving the bag. It's too much to move.
Yes.
But Greg, so 6 weeks. Where did you go, man?
Well, we started off in Auckland, New Zealand. You know, that was our first stop, and we went there and to Milford Sound in there too. Made two stops in New Zealand, which was beautiful. It was amazing. From there, we went to the Maldives. And
I don't even know where that is.
So the Maldives is a speck of a country in the middle of the Indian Ocean that is slowly sinking because of global warming, supposedly.
Oh, well, thanks for making this fun. That was great. Way to depress this interview.
Yeah. But it's in the middle of nowhere. Like, if I show it to you, you go, how does it even plane find this place?
Okay.
It's a dot.
But I did read somewhere that you went swimming with sharks on this trip.
Not this trip. That was last year.
Okay.
We went to the Philippines with her father and her stepmom, and we swam with sharks, with whale sharks. That was pretty fun.
So, you know, you NFL guys have contracts where there are things written in that you can't do. Swimming with sharks is okay? That's an okay thing for NFL guys to do?
You know, these sharks, they just open their mouth wide and swallow plankton. So
you've seen them, but they're like big, slow. They're like fat. They're the Rob Ryan of sharks. You slap a wig, that's what that shark looks like.
But,
it's really slow moving. It's just kind of hanging out.
Greg Salas, Bills wide receiver, hanging out with us. You know, that's what Warren Sapp thought last week, too.
Oh, yeah.
You saw what happened with Warren.
Well, see, these sharks in Killeen, they don't even have teeth. They don't have teeth.
Okay.
They just suck water shark. In, yeah. and it just eats plankton.
It's like this show. It just sucks in crap. And
spits it out. That's what it does. Yeah. Sucks it in, spits it out.
That's it.
So we've been having a debate this morning before you came in about going and playing football at Hawaii. If it's the coolest thing you could ever do or the worst thing you could ever do.
Coolest.
Okay.
By far.
But you're cut off from everything out there, right?
By the way, it's not Gilligan's Island cut off.
Yeah.
It's like they ran a cable out there so you can talk to people.
What I mean is...
Like, what do you think? He's in a hut with like one of those, like, you got to crank it up phones?
You're from California, right?
I'm from California, yes.
So you can only see family. Like, family can't drive out to see your games. You can only see them when you're on break and go home.
No, but they can go to the edge of the shoreline and yell.
I got a piece of string with the Dixie cup, and we hooked it up across the whole entire way.
But, like, okay, normally, guys that go off to college, your friends can hop in a car and come and visit you, right? Your friends have to have a lot of money to get on a plane and come and visit you in Hawaii.
Yeah, they do. And we managed it, you know. I mean, the parents come out for a couple games, you know, the first and last game maybe, and then, you know, it's a lot of West Coast playing, you know, New Mexico, Utah, Fresno, San Jose, so... You know, they got to road trip up to me and see me pretty often during the season.
Greg Salas, Buffalo Bills wide receiver. I mean, listen, if you listen to the experts that talk Bills football, it's Sammy Watkins, it's Robert Woods, and it's a bunch of guys that are just here. How are you feeling about the way you're performing in camp so far?
You know, I feel positive about it. I feel good about it. I've been making plays. I've been doing what the coaches are asking me to do, and you know, making plays when they come to you, and that's all you can do, really. So I'm happy with my performances so far.
You're one of these guys that the experts call a Rex guy, right? Rex signed you when you were when he was in New York. You played with the Jets for a little while. You come here, sign with Rex again. What is it about Rex Ryan that keeps drawing you to his teams?
I don't know. He keeps signing me.
So. Employment.
You know, it's not the other way around. So, I mean, you know, but no, in all seriousness, Rex is he's a great coach. He's a great guy. You love playing for him. He's a player's coach, and, you know, I'm just grateful that he keeps giving me opportunities.
So this is your eighth NFL team, Teron, is that right?
Six.
Six, excuse me.
Lucky
sorry.
Number six, yeah, not there yet.
And you've been on NFL practice squads before?
Yes.
Okay. Talk to me about the difference between the notoriety of putting a jersey on and playing every Sunday and knowing you're putting in the same work every single day that these guys that are playing, but you're not really getting the, what's the word I'm looking for, celebrity of being an NFL football player. I mean, is that frustrating knowing that these guys are going out and getting things that they want and it's cool and you're toiling away in the gym and just practicing with them?
You know, it sucks, you know, putting in the work and not being able to see your work pay off on Sundays, you know, not getting the opportunity to even go out there and give it a shot. So, but you deal with it, you know. You're still in the NFL. You're still keeping your dreams alive. You're still basically auditioning to make the team. And at any point, you know, someone could go down and then – bam, you're up. So, you know, you always got to stay ready and have that positive mindset. Because if you're in a bad place on the practice squad, you're not going to be there for long. You're not going to be putting in the effort. So you just got to remain positive.
The voice you hear in Buffalo Bills wide receiver Greg Salas hanging out in the Stoneyard Brewing Company hot seat. I know you're a vet at this point, but there was a time when you're coming in the league. It's all brand new. Like Reggie Bush could sign yesterday or the other day, and all the young guys freak out. Right? Who was it? Who did we talk to yesterday from USC? Kevon Seymour said that he went and just stood at Reggie's locker and looked at it. Like, that's how amazing he was.
Yeah.
Was there a guy you were starstruck by when you showed up in the league? I won't tell anybody. It's just us talking.
Yeah, Charles Woodson.
Defensive back.
Yeah, yeah. And then getting to actually play against him my rookie year, too, and, you know, making a couple catches on him was, you know, a surreal moment for me, you know, Lambeau Field. I'm sitting there like, this guy I've idolized my whole life, and here he is right now. I'm playing against him on Sunday, so that was a cool and pretty trippy moment.
So, what's it like going from playing in Hawaii to Lambeau Field? God, it's like another planet.
Well, Lambeau, it was early in the season, right, so it was still nice. Yeah, it was beautiful there. But yeah, playing in Hawaii. You know, you get a little spoiled there.
So you grew up a Raiders fan then, if you're a Charles Woodson guy?
Yes.
So when does that go away? I've always wondered this question, right? Like, at what point do you realize I could be a pro and I have to stop cheering for an NFL team now?
Probably when you're getting close to that time, you know, junior, senior year of college, you know, realizing, you know, holy crap, I'm probably going to be playing here with these guys pretty soon. So, you know, you'll be a fan of any team that's going to pick you up pretty much.
Yeah, good point. Yeah. Greg Salas, Buffalo Bills wide receiver. We really appreciate the time, man.
Yeah. No, well, thank you guys for having me on.
Of course.